Hello and welcome back to another episode of Qt Explained. I'm Gunther and today we're having a look at how you can develop Qt 6 apps using Visual Studio. Let's go! As developers, we're always on the lookout for tools that make our lives easier. Today, we're exploring how to develop Qt Quick applications with Microsoft Visual Studio. But this begs the question, why would you want to use Visual Studio in the first place? We can obviously just use Qt Creator as our IDE for Qt projects. Well, the first reason is simple: personal preference and familiarity with the IDE. Windows developers may be used to Visual Studio and may find using it more comfortable than getting into another IDE. It can also increase productivity, especially if you or members of your team are just getting started with Qt and you want to speed up the onboarding process. In addition, Visual Studio is a very powerful IDE with great debugging and code analysis capabilities, an extensive plugin ecosystem, and excellent support for CMake, which allows for seamless integration and easy management of CMake-based Qt projects as well. Lastly, Visual Studio supports a wide range of programming languages, including C++, C#, Visual Basic, JavaScript, TypeScript, and HTML. And of course, even more languages can be supported through various extensions. This is a huge benefit if your project involves a combination of languages or if you already use Visual Studio for other applications or libraries anyway. So you can manage it all from one place then. But of course, there's downsides as well. While Visual Studio is a powerful IDE, it is primarily designed for Windows development. If you want to build your Qt application for other platforms, Qt Creator is definitely the best choice to handle all the different build kits and tool chains that you need. In the same manner, Qt Creator is designed towards Qt development and thus offers the best support to configure Qt projects and run various tools like the QML profiler or Qt Linguist for translations. Another downside is that Visual Studio can be resource intensive compared to Qt Creator, which is a more lightweight IDE. The installation of the Visual Studio Community Edition, which is the smallest one, already needs several gigabytes, while Qt Creator is in the range of a few hundred megabytes. This might be a concern for developers working on less powerful machines. To summarize, the choice between Microsoft Visual Studio and Qt Creator depends on factors such as developer familiarity, the project requirements and involved technologies, your target platforms, as well as the ecosystem and supported tools of each IDE. To configure Visual Studio for Qt development, follow along now and I'll show you the most important extensions and how to set them up. Before jumping into Visual Studio, make sure that you have Qt installed. You also need the MSVC build kit. You can add it with the maintenance tool that comes with the Qt installation. Once we have the Qt libraries and tools available, we can continue to set up Visual Studio. After opening Visual Studio, select the Extensions menu item and choose Manage Extensions. Here you can browse your installed extensions, remove them, or add new ones. To get support for Qt projects, search for the Qt VS Tools extension and install it. This extension enhances Visual Studio to support Qt projects using CMake or QMake. It also adds Qt project wizards and facilitates building, debugging, and auto-completion for Qt code. To also get full QML language support with auto-completion and syntax highlighting, additionally install the QML Syntax Tools extension. Search for QML or QML Syntax and you should find it. After adding the extensions, we have to point Visual Studio to the path of the MSVC build kit of the Qt installation. To do so, navigate to the extensions Qt VS Tools Qt Versions option and click Add New Qt Version. Then choose the bin directory inside of the MSVC build kit of your Qt installation. This ensures a seamless integration and allows Visual Studio to access the Qt libraries and components required by your project. Now everything is set up. We can create and develop Qt projects with Visual Studio. Select File New Project to start the project wizard. You will see that the extension added various wizards, a library project, a console application, or a UI application using Qt widgets or Qt Quick. Let's choose a Qt Quick application, specify the project path, and create the project. Everything is already set up so you can build and run the project. If you open the main CPP, you can see that Visual Studio already recognizes the Qt components and we can start adding code, for example, to include QML context, retrieve the root context from the QML engine and set a context property. You can see that I already get auto-completion for all the components and method calls, which is really nice. Now I want to use this context property in the Qt Quick user interface. So let's check the main.qml file. You'll notice that we have proper language support for QML and we also get auto-completion. So let's add a background rectangle with a light green color. Then we import Qt Quick controls, add a button, and when it's clicked, I change the text to my QML context property. QML auto-completion has helped me out again. The changes are done. So let's hit build and run, and it works. All right, I hope this video was useful to you. I personally think that it's really awesome to have the flexibility of developing Qt applications with the IDE that is best suited for your project. Keep in mind that the right choice between Qt Creator, Visual Studio, or other IDEs depends on your specific needs and preferences, and that you can always switch between different editors depending on the task at hand. Another editor that's great to have in your toolkit and that I personally use a lot is Visual Studio Code. It is very powerful, lightweight, and similar to Visual Studio, the marketplace offers a wide range of useful extensions. For example, the QML Syntax Tools extension for syntax highlighting and auto-completion is available as well. So if you're a fan of Visual Studio Code like me, I highly recommend adding it. To learn more about using Visual Studio or VS Code with Qt, I recommend checking KDEP's content around these topics. You can find some interesting links about the development setup, debugging, and useful IDE features in the video description below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit the like button, and activate the notification bell to not miss any of our videos. Thank you for joining and stay tuned for more. See you next time.